Our team coverage continues now with 10 on Your Side's Liz Palka. She's also live in Portsmouth, the Churchland area. And Liz, you're seeing all types of problems there.
Nicole, there have been tons of things going wrong in the Churchland area of Portsmouth today, and residents are trying to be patient. They're trying to be patient with their vehicles. I can give you an example of that right here. Just take a look down Churchland Boulevard at this silver car down here. That has been there for a couple of hours. I can tell the water is going down just a little bit because when we first got out here, you could barely see that car. Now, right to the right of that car is the Village at Western Branch apartment complex. Again, that's right off Churchland Boulevard near the intersection with West Norfolk and Academy. That apartment complex is flooded out. Take a look at some of this video. I spoke to a resident earlier. His name is Brent Parks. He said he was in his apartment complex around 12:30. All of a sudden, water just started pouring in. He said within 20 minutes, it was ankle deep. He told me he has nothing left. He called his friend over. They tried to gather whatever they could. They tried to get pictures. They tried to get clothing. But he said he doesn't even have a vehicle right now because it, too, is underwater. We've been seeing stories like this all over Churchland today, and we'll have more on Wavy News 10 at 11 tonight. Live in Portsmouth, I'm Liz Palka, 10 on Your Side.
Some serious flooding problems at an apartment building on the peninsula. 10 on Your Side photographer Walter Hildebrand sent us back this video from City Line Apartments in Newport News. We asked if the complex was being evacuated. We were told the evacuation is not mandatory, but some people have decided to leave on their own. Unfortunately, this is one of the places that tends to flood when we get heavy rain. And a frightening rescue this afternoon in Portsmouth. Check out the video of nearly three dozen children being taken out of a flooded KinderCare in Churchland. Portsmouth Fire Department and Virginia Port Authority helped the kids and employees get out by a little boat there. Good news, no injuries. We'll keep our team coverage of the rain going with 10 on Your Side's Aaron Kelly, also in Portsmouth. Aaron, Old Town was underwater for some time this afternoon.
Oh, it's still in some places here. I mean, we're on Effingham Street, and you got to watch your back where I'm standing because depending on how fast the cars are moving, you're getting waves out here. The water is up over the sidewalk here. It's still pretty deep, and cars have been stalling out all afternoon here. This is how deep it is. It's almost up to halfway at my boots. It was up to almost the top of the boots earlier, so it has gone down a little bit, but we have some video of earlier from cars dealing with this. It's just been really difficult. We've seen people driving on the median, parking up on the median, others driving on the sidewalk, doing what they can to try to avoid the deep water here. We talked to one woman who said that the water at one point was up over her wheels, and she decided that she was going to just back out.
I was on my way to work coming from a downtown tunnel, and my client live up here on Effingham. As soon as I came out the tunnel, traffic had a standstill. Nobody going anywhere. And I turned my car around and came over here and parked and said, I'm going to wait until the water subsides. I'm not trying to damage my car. It's already old.
Good advice there. A lot of people have been waiting it out in the parking lot behind us here, just waiting for the water to go down. But I can tell you, even if you're walking, it is miserable out here. You're going to have soggy feet wherever you go. It's really hard to avoid anywhere around Effingham, and I'm sure in a lot of places across Hampton Roads tonight. That's the latest live in Portsmouth. Aaron Kelly, 10 on Your Side.
All right, let's switch now to 10 on Your Side's Jason Marks. Jason, you've seen a lot of flooding and people pushing cars on Tidewater Drive in Norfolk. How's it looking now?
We're still flooded. I mean, take a look at this right here. This is Virginia Beach Boulevard, and you can see, especially as these cars are coming through here at this intersection, I mean, you can see how this water still is. Now, before, when we first got here, we couldn't see the line in the middle of the road. Now we can see that, so that's good news. So the water is going down. As you mentioned, though, it's been a nightmare for drivers. I mean, take a look at the other side of the street, right in front of that police car, that Chris Pan over there, and you can see there's just a line of cars that are now, that's not a lane people should be stopped in. That has really become the graveyard of cars. Cars that tried to make it through this intersection. We talked with people who just say it was raining so hard as they were coming through. They didn't realize the water was so deep and they couldn't see it like you can see now. And they, before they knew it, they started to go through and they just, their car stalled out. And so then you had people jumping out of their cars, helping to push the cars over there. Actually, we talked with a couple who was leaving the Norfolk courthouse. They actually just got married And so they're driving home and they're coming through this intersection. Now, they were in a Jeep, a very high Jeep, so they weren't having to worry about stalling out, but they decided to jump out. Not even half an hour after they say their vows, they're jumping out and helping to push car after car after car. And we've seen that all day long. As we mentioned, good news, it's going down, but you still don't want to drive through. It's still too high to go through. And hopefully, though, here in the next hour, hour and a half, this water will be gone and then things will get back to normal. Guys, really made for a nightmare, and it's still making for a nightmare of a commute on your way home. Now back to you.
Oh, and what a story that couple has to share about their wedding day. Thanks, Jason. Down to your side also has this video of a Churchland High School bus that went off the road in Portsmouth. The scene here, Dunkirk Street and Tire Neck Road. No one was hurt. Another bus was brought in to take the students home.